for tuning in to Mera Now. You're watching News with me, Tanvi Shukla. First up, quick look at the headlines. Over 2,000 farmers commit suicide from January 1st to October 31st. Mera Now accesses proof that exposes the gravity of Maharashtra's agrarian crisis. Over 12,000 results still pending, leaving thousands of students in the lurch. Instead of penalizing the company responsible for the mess, Mumbai University pays 1 crore rupees for the online assessment. For students of a private school from Bangalore were in for a rude shock. Glass panel falls on them from the 4th floor. 2 students left severely injured. So Mega Mera Now impact. Kota Municipal Corporation rolls back the outrageous proposal for sanitation tax that looked to discriminate against outsider students. Haryana government takes note of the exorbitant charges that Fortis Hospital forms an inquiry team to probe the 16 lakh bill. In a brazen move to gag the media, Karnataka Assembly orders the arrest of 2 journalists, rejects the appeal to review its privilege motion. An 85-year-old man arrested in connection with rape of 4 children in Hyderabad. The 85-year-old pervert allegedly also tried to molest 2 other minors. Your Assam Health Minister makes a bizarre comment, says cancer is divine justice. His explanation, that the disease is God's way of punishing sinners. A woman constable files plea in the Bombay High Court seeking permission to undergo sex reassignment surgery yet continue working in the police force. A massive setback for the Sasikala camp. Election Commission allots the 2-leaf symbol to the Paneer Selvam Palaniswamy faction. Mera Now campaign to make Mumbai's locals safe continues. We'll show you the progress on promises made by the government to build the 3 new footover bridges. But the Karnataka Assembly has rejected the appeal to review its privilege motion order against 2 journalists. Karnataka Speaker K.B. Kolivar, who actually moved one of the complaints himself in 2014, has now asked the police to arrest the 2 journalists. The big question that we are asking is, should lawmakers be allowed to act as jury on their own complaints and misuse their privilege against the 4th state?
Editor of, Bengaluru, Hi Bengaluru, as well as another journalist named Anil Raju, editor of Yelahanka Voice, had of course written articles consistently against MLAs, including KB Kolivar as well as Vishwanath, is what we are given to understand. And they've of course took contempt to this, and they immediately filed a complaint against them. But we also given to understand by the advocate who are representing both the journalists, in fact, saying that they went about writing more and more articles which they found it very defamatory, and that was for the first time that we are seeing that they had filed a case against them. And then a privilege house committee was formed, and this house committee was formed by when Kagodu Timmappa was a speaker back then. But however, this 2 committees were formed for both the journalists. While one committee was headed by Kolivar, the other committee was also headed, which was looking after, in fact, as far as the High Bengaluru is concerned, Ravi Belagre.
On to the latest coming in on the controversy surrounding Fortis Hospital. The Haryana government has formed an inquiry team to probe the charges against the Fortis Hospital. The team will submit a report within 3 days. The Gurugram Hospital had charged the family of a 7-year-old dengue patient almost 16 lakh rupees for treatment for 15 days in the ICU. Now, the family alleges that they have been overcharged by the hospital.
the entire controversy surrounding the Fortis Hospital, earlier a district-level probe panel was set up, a three-member panel was set up under the CMO to probe into this report and to come up with ascertain the facts of what has happened. But now it has been given to a high-level panel which comprises of two officers from Panchkula, two administrative medical officers from Panchkula, one CMO of Gurugram and a couple of officers from the district administration. And this is a high-level panel that will now be looking into this entire matter. The panel has already met with the father in question and they had discussed what happened. The panel heard the side of the father today morning and now they will also be hearing the side of the Fortis Hospital, and they are likely to come up with their report very soon is what we are getting to hear. Now, more importantly, we are being also told that this particular panel will also be submitting their report to the Haryana Health Minister Anil Vij, and also as JP Nadda, the Health Minister, had also asked for a report from the state government after taking cognizance of a complaint that went viral on social media. So we are hoping that this particular panel soon sends its report to the state government as well as the central government so that some kind of facts are being ascertained in this case by this high-level panel.
यह अत्यंत ही अमानवीय घटना है. मुझे लगता है कि जब मानवता शून्य हो जाता है तो इस प्रकार की बुद्धि पनपती है. और जो मुझे लगता है कि जो प्राइवेट क्लिनिक है या नर्सिंग होम है उनके लिए भी एथिक्स है, मेडिकल एथिक्स है. उस मेडिकल एथिक्स को सबको व्यवहार बनाना चाहिए और इस पर यह घटना घटी है, विभाग को संज्ञान में आया है और इस पर निश्चित रूप से जांच होगी और जांच प्रक्रिया के बाद जो भी चीज निकलता है उस पर कार्रवाई होगी.
Moving on, Mumbai University has failed its students again. Despite missing two deadlines given by the Bombay High Court, the Mumbai University is yet to declare over 12,000 re-evaluation results. In spite of all the flaws in the online system, it looks like the varsity has granted a sum of 1.18 crore rupees to the same company, MeritTrack, who was allegedly responsible for the entire mess and the delay in results.
We reached out to both the university officials as well as the company MeritTrack itself, who has been given this tender of conducting the online assessment of the Mumbai University. And the version that is coming from the company side is that they did their job properly. They came in a bit much later, even after the exams were done, the final exams were conducted. After that, they were hired to do the job and they did the job in less than the stipulated time given to them. And despite that fact, all the allegations that have been made against them is what they are dismissing at this point, and they are also somewhere pointing fingers at the Mumbai University for also not doing their job properly, and they are not ready to take the burden of blame on themselves solely. But on the other hand, the university officials are stating that all the 12,000 results will be declared. They have not still given a deadline despite missing two deadlines that were given to them by the Bombay High Court. Despite that, they still haven't said that this will be the deadline for which the students will not have to wait beyond this, clearly showing that the university still hasn't brought their act properly and they need to do something now at immediate basis, because the students are suffering on account of this, and the students are the ones whose years have been lost, job opportunities have gone out of their hands, and also chances of further studies are also standing pending because results have not been declared.
मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी ने जो मेरिटेक कंपनी को करीब 1,18,00,000 रुपए देने का काम किया है, जिस कंपनी की वजह से पूरा ब्लंडर हुआ. एक जगह सरकार ने वहाँ के जो वीसी थे उसे निकालने का काम किया है, लेकिन जिस कंपनी की वजह से पूरा मामला हुआ है वहाँ कहीं ना कहीं तो उसे बचाने का काम सरकार भी कर रही है, मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी भी कर रही है. हमारा इतना ही कहना है कि जिस कंपनी को जिस तरह से टेंडर के लिए सभी जो उसके नियम थे, जो अलग अलग जो उसके रूल्स थे, उसे उन्होंने कहीं ना कहीं तो बदल करके उसे मदद करने का भी पहले काम किया और उसके बाद उसे बड़े पैमाने पर पेमेंट भी दे रहे हैं. हमने राज्यपाल को भी पत्र लिखा है कि इस कंपनी को ब्लैकलिस्ट किया जाए, उसे जुर्माना लिया जाए, और आने वाले दिनों में जो भी कंपनी अच्छा रिजल्ट दे सकती है उसका सरकार एक रिव्यू करे और उसके बाद काम दे, ताकि जो आने वाले दिनों में ऑनलाइन जो असेसमेंट जो सिस्टम है वो कभी प्रभावित ना हो और इस साल जो तकलीफ हुई है वो अगले साल तकलीफ ना हो.
Basically, the students have been taken as lab rats. So experiments have been done on us. And unfortunately, it's been already 6-7 months that the results, the main results are not out. Many courses yet, the main results were not out. And this company, Meritrack, why don't you just blacklist this company? Rather than that, rather than blacklisting the company, the university is going on paying them money.
There are many students who have lost their scholarships and they have lost their whole 1 year because just because university has not declared their results on time. And still, rather than imposing fine on Meritrack, university are clearing their bills.
बहुत सारे ऐसे problems हैं जो EMA वाले हैं और उनके पास ऐसी बहुत सारी बातें आई हैं कि बहुत सारे लोगों के कापियाँ जो हैं गायब कर दी गई हैं और फिलहाल वो रजिस्ट्रार वगैरह इन सारे लोगों के पास अगर जा रहे हैं तो अपने कमरे को बंद करके और बाकायदे अंदर बैठे हुए हैं और सीधा एक बात कह रहे हैं कि मुझे किसी से मिलने के लिए ना दिया जाए और मैं किसी से मिलना नहीं चाहता.
Well, let's also take a look at what else is making news across the country. Actor Varun Dhawan was fined by the Mumbai police after a picture of him taking a selfie with a fan in the middle of traffic went viral. In the picture, the actor can be seen clicking a selfie in the middle of the road. The Mumbai police issued a challan and warned of stricter action. The actor replied to that tweet, issuing an apology. After months of battle over Tuli's symbol, the Election Commission finally allotted the AIADMK symbol. The Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Palaniswamy joined faction. This comes as a big blow to the Shashikala camp. 27-year-old woman died after she fell from the 10th floor of the Cessna Business Park in Bengaluru. The victim has been identified as Gitanjali Madelkar, a senior engineer in one of the global firms hailing from Goa. She was on a two-day leave when the incident occurred. Ahead of the second test match with Sri Lanka and Nagpur, Indian captain Virat Kohli slammed the cricketing body for its poor planning. Kohli stressed on the importance of rest for players and blamed the BCCI for leaving the team with no time to prepare for the upcoming matches. According to Virat Kohli, excess cricket is hampering the team's performance.
Yes, because unfortunately we get only 2 days before we fly to South Africa after this series gets over. So we have no choice but to, you know, be in game situation and think of what's coming ahead for us. Had we got a month off, ideally, you know, we would have done a proper preparation in a camp sort of a scenario. But we have to, you know, sort of make do with what we have. As usual, cram for time, which I think we need to assess in future.
An 85-year-old man has been arrested in connection with the rape of 4 children. The case was investigated by Hyderabad's SHE team and then handed over to the police. On to a mirror now. Impact, the Kota Municipal Corporation has rolled back the sanitation tax that was to be levied on coaching institutions that had majority of outsider students. This after Mirana's relentless coverage highlighting this outrageous policy that looked to discriminate against the outsiders.
It is a mega Mirana's impact because Mirana's has pursued this story relentlessly since morning, and we have questioned every authority there in Kota that why such arbitrary tax has been imposed only on coaching students. And now the Mahesh Vijay, the mayor of Kota, has announced that there would be no such tax on anybody, not the coaching student, nor on the other school going students. Clearly what has happened here today is that Kota Municipal Corporation's Revenue Committee saw these coaching institute students coming from all across the country as milch cows, and what they wanted to do is to fleece ₹1,000 per head per year for as sanitation tax. But clearly Mirana has raised their voice of the coaching students who have come from all across, all nook and corner from the country. They live here, they give big fees to the coaching institute, and obviously this was an arbitrary tax which has now been taken back.
Moving on, it's been 60 days since a deadly stampede claimed 23 lives at Mumbai's Elphinstone station. But the ground reality continues to disappoint. Close to 1 month since the Railways Minister announced new footover bridges for Elphinstone station, only pre-construction work has begun on ground. Today, a team from the Army visited the all three stations to inspect the site. On Mirror Now, we ask, will the January 2018 deadline that has been set by the Union Minister be met at all?
Well, it's been a month since CM Devendra Fadnavis announced that the army will build bridges at Elphinstone, at Curry Road station and at Ambivali station here in the city of Mumbai. And 1 month post that, we see that the army has begun inspection here at all of these stations. Currently, safety precautions are being looked at by these army officials. We learn that the design has been approved by the Western Railway officials. However, officials at the railways tell us that the commissioner of railway safety has to approve the design, and only then can the construction work begin here at all these stations. We also learn that the work will happen only between 2 and 4 a.m. in the night every day. And remember, there is a deadline. January 31st, 2017 is a deadline that's been given, and the big question is whether they will be able to deliver and build these bridges by 31st of January, considering they're already a month late. Amitabh Balachandra for Mirror Now.
Lalita Salve, a constable, has filed a plea in Bombay High Court seeking permission to undergo a sex reassignment surgery and continue working in the police force. She was denied permission by the police officials on technical grounds of the minimum height for a male and a female constable. Now, Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis has stepped in, asking the Home Department to consider this case.
एप्लीकेशन के टाइम पे कोई अड़चने आई क्या आपको? क्या हुआ, कैसा सफ़र था वो एप्लीकेशन? अभी भी आपको परमिशन मिली है, वो एप्लीकेशन मिला है आपको?
एप्लीकेशन करके तो दो आठ महीना दो एक दो महीने हो गए थे, मगर परमिशन आया नहीं. बाद में उन्होंने परमिशन के लिए ना कर दिया, तो फिर हम बॉम्बे हाईकोर्ट चले.
तो परमिशन के लिए क्यों मना किया? क्या वो बता क्या रहे हैं, रीज़न क्या बता रहे हैं?
उन्होंने सर्विस रूल और रिक्रूटमेंट रूल है, उसमें वो फ़र्क कर रहे हो. उनका कहना है कि इनका जो नियुक्ति है, अपॉइंटमेंट हो, वो फीमेल वर्कर हुई है, महिला आरक्षण में हुई है. तो जब ये ऑपरेशन सर्जरी करेंगे तब ये मेल हो जाएंगे, पुरुष हो जाएंगे. तो पुरुष का उनका नियुक्ति नहीं हम कर सकते, पुरुष के फायदे हम नहीं देंगे इनको, ऐसा उनका कहना है.
तो अभी अगर हम बताएं तो अभी आप बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट में आए, आपको उम्मीद क्या है? आपको लगता है कि पुलिस की तरफ से जो परमिशन, बिकॉज आप बता रहे कि जे हॉस्पिटल को वो परमिशन लेटर चाहिए आपके ऑफिस से, अभी आपको उम्मीद क्या रही है? क्योंकि पुलिस ने आपका साथ नहीं दिया, अब आपको लगता है कि पुलिस आपका साथ देना चाहिए?
अभी तो मैं बॉम्बे हाईकोर्ट आई मेरे हक के लिए, तो मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है कि माननीय हाईकोर्ट मुझे परमिशन देगा.
वो फीमेल इसमें लगे, फीमेल रिक्रूटमेंट में. अब जब ये पुरुष हो जाएंगे या मेल हो जाएंगे तब इनको सर्विस नहीं, सर्विस में नहीं रखा जाएगा. अच्छा. इस चीज पर आधार पर उन्हें नकारी. और उनकी वो जब हाइट थी 162 और वो पुरुष के लिए 165, तो ये एक कारण उन्होंने दिया है.
Also, some news that we track very closely here on Mirror Now, India's agrarian crisis. Mirror Now is access proof. It completely exposes how government after government have just asked farmers, have used farmers like a poll tool. The latest government figures accessed by Mirror Now show that over 2,000 farmers have taken their lives between January 1st and October 31st this year. Of this, almost 1,000 farmers ended their lives between July and October. That is after the Maharashtra government announced the farm loan waiver. Mandar Fanse filed this report.
Horrible situation as of now, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, on the grounds of farmers, because the farmers overall committing suicide since the loan waiver which was been announced to the tune of 34,000 crore rupees by the Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis. As of now, the death toll of the farmers is 1,020 farmers have been committed suicide across Maharashtra. Apart from that, this particular number, actually, if you really go back to the January to October month of deaths of farmers, especially especially the farm suicides. The real suicide number is 2,414 people, the farmers who have committed suicide. Within these 2,414 farm suicides, the eligible farm suicides so far are 1,277 farmers. So that means there is a eligibility criteria for even the farm suicides, and that's why these numbers are even half of what the numbers actually has happened on the ground when it comes to farm suicides. Apart from this, when it comes to the 34,000 crore rupees of a big bonanza which was declared in the month of June by the Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis in Maharashtra, actually on the ground right now till today, in the first phase of disbursement of farm loans, only 55,000 farmers have been benefited across Maharashtra, and that particular 55,000 farmers has so far got only 391 crore rupees. So that means only 391 crore rupees have been disbursed so far since June. That is the snail speed at which the farm loans were disbursed. This is 34,000 crore rupees, as we know. The loan waivers which were declared, that were basically meant for the Kharif season. The Kharif season has got over. Now even the Rabi sowing season will get over eventually by the month of December. And that's why this is really a grave crisis for the farmers across Maharashtra, be it in Marathwada, be it in Vidarbha and North Maharashtra especially. The number of the death toll is especially very high from Vidarbha and then followed by Marathwada.
That's all the time we have, and as we wrap up this show, let's leave you with some good news. Indian Navy has inducted its first ever woman pilot. Shubhangi Swaroop will now undergo training at the Dundigal Air Force Academy in Hyderabad.